I do it in English, huh?
Yeah, we do it in English.
Okay.
On peut parler en français aussi.
Comme tu veux.
Mais pour les auditeurs,
c'est better. Easier.
Il y a plus d'auditeurs en anglais que en français. What is your story about Sarajevo? Because you are a French guy and you was in Sarajevo. You opened the gallery there. But why Sarajevo?
Actually, I was a student at the art school in Paris, l'École nationale des beaux-arts de Paris. It was in 2000. And I got this Erasmus exchange program. Mm-hmm. So I have been for more or less half a year at the Art Academy in Sarajevo as a student. Uh-huh. There I was still working for myself, let's say, as an artist. I was doing a lot of print making and painting mostly. And I slowly met many students, young artists, teachers, professors, and I started to know a bit more about Sarajevo and about Bosnia. Right after the 6 months, I've been back to Paris to finish my studies. Mm-hmm. But before leaving, I promised many friends there that I will come back and I will try to do something. Because at that time there is almost no gallery space, let's say, and it was really, really hard for the younger generation to show their artwork. So I've been back to Paris for 2 years more to get my diploma. I got it, and then in early 2004, I came back to Sarajevo. And I really started to work on that idea to open a gallery space.
Why Sarajevo? Because you have to, probably you can choose many other cities.
Because this 6 months of exchange, I don't know exactly what happened in my mind, but of course, when I arrived the first time in 2001, I was quite shocked. Really met young artists, young persons to explain you what they did during the war, well, how they find a way to survive, etc. I was thinking to myself, there is something really unique and really special here. Mm-hmm. And step by step, I also discovered the artworks that artists were doing, and they were really, really super strong.
How was the art scene at that time in Sarajevo?
It was a really tiny art scene because, of course, during the war and right after the war, many artists have moving back to France, Switzerland, in many countries in all Europe. Some of them are still living there, but many of them came back too. So this is what one part of the artists, and the other part that I met was students. Actually, and they were super, how can I say, exciting. They were, because there was something, there was something to rebuild, there was something to do. So now, after the war, let's say you have to fight for good reason, you have to fight for culture, you have to fight for art. Because I'm French too, it was a bit easier for me to go to some embassies, to do some nice application, to get some funds. I know how to do that. Because the art market almost doesn't exist. So I really found the best place to open a gallery where there is no art market. So it's almost a paradox. So the gallery really needs to be supported by foundation or embassies. And it's how we started, early 2004. Actually, in a very small space of 10 meters square. That's why the very first gallery was called Galleria 10 meters square, because it was really 10 meters square on the floor, a bit less, to be honest, a bit less than 10 meters square. But the most important was not to have a huge gallery space, but to have our spot, our place where we can do whatever we want.
And was it a cultural shock when you entered to Sarajevo, which was after the war, a lot of buildings were destroyed, the art market was ruined, and the artists probably what they can say in this situation.
The artists from Serbia, Croatia, they were always strongly linked. Ça veut dire, let's say, in many friends that I know, I have many friends in Serbia, in Croatia, they are constantly moving in between, and actually it's super easy. Let's say. It goes really well. I've been there also many times to Belgrade, to Zagreb. I invited many Serbian artists to exhibit in Sarajevo. For most of them, it was the first time after the war that they came back to Sarajevo. And it was always a huge success, and they were always super welcome. I never had any troubles about that. Maybe because they were artists are very well educated, or they are a bit more, let's say, quiet about that kind of topic. But I really have some really strong souvenir of artists from Serbia coming, and at the opening exhibition, it was full, completely full. Everybody came to see them and to see what they were doing. It was a really good sign.
I can imagine that this 10 square meter was not enough for a long time. And you did extended it for for 100 meters square meters. So how this happened?
In 2008, actually, I was looking for years a building next to the Galleria 10 meter square. But at that time, I didn't have enough money to rent it. But I was looking at this empty building for years, really for years. And 2009, I got a new sponsors. The Agnès B Foundation in Paris, and they decided to support us, and with that new help, I got enough money to rent finally that building that I was looking for years actually. So we keep the 10 meter square gallery, and the other building was very next to the gallery, and we rebrand with the new name of Duplex 100 meter square. Because it was more time, really 100 meters square. And of course we continue with the same idea to support the local art scene. Was always one of the main goals, let's say. And I will say that more or less 70% of the exhibition was made by the artists from Bosnia. And time to time, we are invited artists from Serbia, from France, from Hungary, from all Europe. But it's 70% local and 30% more or less international.
What can we see here in Art Market Budapest?
For Milomir, it's a long story with him because we are working together since a very long time, since almost the beginning of the gallery. So I'm a big fan of his artwork, it's of photography. So he's doing only photography. He's always having a classical Leica, Argentic way of doing. Silver print, really nicely done at home in his apartment. This series is called the Innocent Saints Fragment. Actually, there is a bit more or less 100 small pieces. From the full collection. So I did a small selection of a few of them.
You are also a collector. And this is very interesting because I think the percentage about the collecting paintings and collecting photography is, you know, everyone wants the oil in frame.
I'm not collecting only photography. I have a lot of photography in the collection, but I have also paintings, objects, serigraphy, gravure. I have many things. But actually, that collection project started when I was in Paris, when I was a student. Actually, I was doing drawings, and I start to exchange artworks with my friends. Okay, I like this drawing. You give me that one, and I give you one of mine. So it's how it started, just by exchange. And I started this project in more or less in 2000, let's say. And I still today continue to do that. So I still have my home production of drawings and paintings. But I still continue to exchange. So I collect through that way, doing exchange. And all the other artworks that I have, I got it from a donation from the artist. Actually, I never bought any artworks.
No.
Never. So just like donation and exchange.
Yeah, there was a selection in the National Gallery of Bosnia.
Actually, it was a really nice show because I was hesitating actually what to do. Option one was to do a selection, or option two was to show everything. And actually, I decided to not put anyone left. That's why I call this exhibition Sarajevo Storage, because it was pragmatically every single artwork that I have on the storage at that moment. Mm-hmm. And then I have a good news since a few days. I exhibited the collection in the National Gallery of Sarajevo 3 years ago. A year later was in the Art Center of Tuzla. And now, good news, it will be exhibited in the new Art Center Krak in Bihać next April. So I'm really happy to go back to Bosnia in April to show again the collection.
Thank you very much for this conversation.